How's this for an issue to tackle? What do you do when nobody is buying your product and you don't know how to launch it because everyone wants to get to it first in a marketplace where everything is free? Can you guess the industry I'm talking about? Well, the music business is tackling this issue right now. And the plain truth is that nobody is buying albums and everybody is trying to get free singles quicker than the artists even release them. All over the world, more and more people, as you know, are getting their music for free and they're getting it digitally. And very often, they're getting it even before the artist releases it. And it's especially true for top artists in emerging markets. So when you think about this problem, it's a really interesting marketing challenge. And when a top Norwegian band came to see us, called Kaiser's Orchestra, we thought that it was a terrific marketing challenge to actually turn the marketing funnel and the entire challenge of trying to sell something that is already available many times for free on its head. So Kaiser's Orchestra was getting ready to release a new album and a new single, and they wanted a new way to market it. Our solution was to basically stop fighting the old business model, stop trying to keep that afloat, and instead focus on what people wanted after all, which was to give them a chance to actually experience the music and own the music in their own way, even before it was released. So what Starcom did was to challenge the youth of Norway to basically cover the new song, Hurtsekanuser, and to cover it even before it was released. So to continue the story, let's go ahead and roll the video.
Kaiser's Orchestra is one of Norway's top artists, and they were getting ready to release a new single as an introduction to the upcoming album. This time, though, they wouldn't give anybody a chance to steal it. They'd launch a record without even recording it. Fans hunger for new material, which is great for bands, but they're less keen on paying for it, which is not great for bands. Fans will turn out in droves to see their bands live, so the best chance at making money is ticket sales. Because album sales are going down, people are attending more and more concerts. Kaiser's Orchestra decided they'd rather win fans in the long term rather than sell a record in the short term. New release would be released, but not as a CD or MP3, and not on vinyl. It would be released on paper, on posters, through torrent sites, and via music and fan forums. We released the sheet music first, 1 month before the song's release. We challenged Norway, can you cover Kaiser's Orchestra's next single, Jetteknuser, before you've even heard it? We collaborated with the largest music schools in Norway, where we faxed the sheet music to be copied and distributed among students. Hey, it's just a piece of paper, it's easy to distribute. We engaged national radio broadcaster NRK's youth channel, P3, and encouraged people to upload their versions to P3's popular website. Soon, fans started posting their covers of Jetteknuser, ranging across all different genres. Even a German version appeared. The word spread, and Kaiser's Orchestra and their challenge soon became the hot topic of bloggers, Twitterers, fans, and the press. The challenge even got coverage on national TV. Finally, it was time to release the original Kaiser's Orchestra, Jetteknuser. Instantly, the original and the three best cover versions all got heavy radio rotation. During the challenge, Kaiser's Orchestra's Facebook fan base increased by 100%, gathering one of the biggest fan bases in social media for Norwegian artists. Our media spending of only 800 euros created more than 500,000 actions in social media and created media coverage worth more than 1 million euros. Kaiser's Orchestra's concert at one of Norway's largest venues sold out without advertising. Within 48 hours of the launch, Jette Knuse had reached number 2 on the Norwegian iTunes Top 10 chart, making it Kaiser's Orchestra's fastest-selling single on iTunes ever. The album Violetta Violetta reached the number 1 spot in Norwegian charts in the first week of its release. When fans find themselves in your music, you've made it as a band.
The reason I love this case is that it really delivers on what we call the 4 C's: currency, conversation, content, and community. The currency and the content in this case is the song itself. In order to hear the music, you had to cover it yourself even before it was released. And that created thousands and thousands of opportunities to seed the conversation, to get it out to bloggers, to get it out to websites, in order for people to get interested, want to own the song, and then interpret and cover it themselves. Once we had the sheet music delivered out, then we further fueled conversation and further fueled content around it by basically tapping all the music and the fan sites that would keep that conversation going. And as the word spread, what we were able to see that these conversations were then amplified into mainstream media, and it became a pretty hot topic for national television coverage, not only those covering music, but also the national news in Norway as well. We were able to tap into the community and the fan base by actually going in and talking to music schools and music students and encouraging them to collaborate and create around the music. We were able to get some real credibility there by getting actual artists to want to sign up to cover the song. So with one piece of sheet music, we were able to convince the youth and citizens of Norway to create over 100 covers of the song, again, even before it was released, and to talk about it and create content around it that kept fueling the interest in the song and the album. The results were really terrific. It was the number one selling album in Norway. It was the number one selling song in Norway on iTunes. It sold more songs for Kaiser's Orchestra, or more songs for Kaiser Orchestra than any other song or album that they had released in the previous years. And it doubled their Facebook fan base. So the results were really fantastic. And it did really create a new type of way to build content, to build conversation, and to launch and monetize something that previously people were having difficulty with getting paid for. So it was a pretty bold decision, a really successful case, and we're really proud of it. Thank you.